Hello, I'm Clantus. If you are new to my YouTube channel, welcome to the clan. So about 3 weeks ago, I had a very unfortunate interaction with a YouTuber who was quite brand new on the platform. Her channel was growing real fast because the content that she was posting on her channel was awesome and the quality of her videos were on point and she had it going. As a result of that, she was growing real fast. I think the reason why she was growing real fast is because she did some background work asking people to subscribe to her YouTube channel. People that she worked with, family members, neighborhood, you name it, she asked them all. However, this lady, one thing that got me very concerned was the fact that about two of her videos, she had used popular music. I went to her comment section just to advise her that if she does not want her channel to be terminated, she must either go and edit out the popular music, because definitely that popular music is copyrighted. Well, she ignored me. So I tried several times. I even went as far as going to her Instagram DM, where I tried once again to advise her to go and mute the music in her video's background. Well, unfortunately, South African arrogance kicked in. Then she uploaded her third video, and in that video, once again, it had a new popular music in the background. So just when I was about to click and watch the video, it was gone. And I just knew what had just happened. Her YouTube channel was terminated. About 2 days later, I get a DM. Guess from who? Yeah, you guessed it right, from her, asking me what could have happened that she had lost her YouTube channel. In my mind, I'm like, oh, so you did see my comments, but you decided to ignore them. Within a space of 2 or 3 weeks, she managed to get 5,000 subscribers organically, I believe, because she told me that she had done the background work before she even started her channel and sent it and basically told everybody she knew on Facebook, you name it, to please subscribe to her YouTube channel. And people indeed did come and subscribe. So now she's panicking and she's crying and she's all stressed out. And then I said to her, well, I hope you had listened to me while you still had two videos with popular music, because that only meant that you were only left with one last strike. So YouTube gives you 3 copyright strikes before it terminates your YouTube channel. Then I had to deliver the bad news to her, like, unfortunately, you can't appeal this one, and therefore your YouTube channel and every video that you ever posted on your YouTube channel is now gone and you can't get it back. Then she asked me, why is it that when I'm trying to create another channel, I'm being refused? Then I was like, I'm not quite sure, but I think maybe you are banned from YouTube to create another YouTube channel. And then just when I was done with this lady, another one popped up. But this one, she was bashing and bullying other content creators on YouTube. Basically, every big YouTuber in South Africa, she went after them. And I was not going to have it, because that meant every content creator in South Africa were on her hit list, and there was no way that I was going to allow a fellow YouTuber violate community guidelines of YouTube by bashing other content creators instead of adding value to the people that are subscribed to her channel. So I did take issue with her on her comment section in public for everybody to see that what she was doing was wrong. But of course, once again, South African arrogance kicked in. As a result, I thought, you know what? I've done everything that I could. You leave me with no choice but to report your videos. And so I did. I did report the videos, and indeed she did violate community guidelines of YouTube, but the only time she is going to see that she is in trouble with YouTube is when she tries to monetize the channel. Remember, before your channel gets monetized, it goes through a process of review, and the review is done by humans. So one of the things that they check when they review your channel is to see if your channel or any of your videos violated any community guidelines, YouTube policies, copyright policies, as well as advertiser-friendly guidelines. So if you have not violated any of those, then your channel gets accepted into the YouTube Partner Program. Because at the end of the day, as YouTubers, guys, we are here to add value to someone else's life. We are not here to bash people, bully people, because all that is against YouTube policies. As you can see the title of the video, YouTube rules that you should know. So if you wish to make money on YouTube, then you are subject to community guidelines, copyright provisions, advertiser friendly content guidelines, as well as YouTube policies as a whole. That also includes COPPA. So let's start with what exactly is YouTube community guidelines. So YouTube has set up some common sense rules that applies to all YouTubers, and that includes people that are users of the platform. And amongst those common sense rules are: do not harass other people on YouTube, don't bash and bully other people on YouTube, don't post violent videos on YouTube, don't post sex related material on YouTube unless it is for the purposes of education, documentary, or artistic value. And definitely no drug consumption related material on YouTube is allowed unless they are for educational purposes, where you share your story about how you recovered as a drug addict. But do not show images of people using drugs of any kind. YouTube also has other specific rules that YouTubers should not violate, knowingly or unknowingly. YouTube community guidelines applies to everything you do on YouTube. Everything. And that also includes your thumbnails, the title of your YouTube videos, copyright, as well as advertiser-friendly content guidelines. So I advise you to familiarize yourself with the community guidelines, everything that is there. Some of them I have not included in this video because I want you to go and do some homework. Read them to understand them, because they have an effect on your YouTube channel, period. So what happens if you violated one of the YouTube community guidelines? So the first thing that will happen, you are going to get a warning from YouTube the first time it happens. However, if it happens again, you are going to receive an email, but this time you are going to be hit with a community guideline strike. But the good news is community guideline strikes only last for 90 days. However, if you are hit with 3 community guideline strikes, then your YouTube channel is going to be queued for termination. Unfortunately, at this point in time, you are not going to be able to appeal the third strike. Please do understand this. When your YouTube channel is terminated by YouTube, that includes every video you have posted on your channel. All goes away along with your channel. Imagine all that hard work gone, just like that. Like I said earlier on, if it happens that you commit a YouTube community guideline violation, YouTube is going to send you an email and let you know of the violation. And in that email, they are also going to send you information how you can appeal if you think YouTube has made a mistake. Please listen to this. If you are going to use someone else's music in your videos, be rest assured that you are going to get a copyright strike. So be careful. Don't use popular music, because it is copyrighted, period. Instead, use YouTube Music Library, or you can go to a third-party music provider, like, is it Epidemic Sounds, Epidemic Music, what is it called? One of that. They have a variety of copyright-free music that you can use. You can also go to bandsound.com. Basically, there it's a website that has copyright-free music. However, you have to recognize them in your description box where you got the sound from. Copyright is different from YouTube community guidelines. And here is the overview of what exactly is copyright. The important thing that you need to understand about copyright is that it is a legal right that gives the creator of the original work the executive right to determine how their material can be used. In a nutshell, what this means is you cannot use someone else's work without the owner's permission. Believe it or not, this also includes singing someone else's song or reciting someone else's musical lyrics. So if it does happen that you did include a copyrighted material on your videos, then YouTube will execute what is called a takedown notice. This simply means that YouTube is just going to take down that video. Because at the end of the day, YouTube is responsible to prevent any of its platform content creators from repetitively using copyright material on the platform. Hence, YouTube has copyright strike system. If you receive 3 strikes, then your YouTube channel is going to get terminated by YouTube. Please be alert of this. There is no warning when you are hit with a third copyright strike. However, the first 2 have no impact on your channel or any of your material on YouTube. Again, I would advise you to please go read up on copyright, on YouTube policies, so that you get to understand it and befriend it and know what is expected of you as a content creator. This is serious. It's serious. Okay? Listen to me. Thirdly, so you want to make money on YouTube, so listen up, because this one is important. So in order for you to get monetized on YouTube, well, you know the drill. You need to have 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 hours of public watch time on YouTube within 12 months. Once you become eligible for monetization, meaning that you already have the 1,000 subscribers and the 4,000 hours of public watch time, then your YouTube channel is going to go for a review. And the review is done by a human being. And the things that they are going to check during the review is the things that I've already talked about in this very video. Copyright. They are also going to check if your videos are advertiser friendly, which I'm going to talk about a little in detail just now, as well as community guidelines. If any of the community guidelines have been violated, they are going to check your thumbnails. They are going to check your video titles. And once they are satisfied, they are going to either accept you into the YouTube partner program or reject you. They are going to tell you what are the reasons why they rejected your YouTube channel from getting monetized. So you see why you need to listen to me? Listen to me. Listen to me. If you are under 1,000 subscribers, that also includes if you are monetized as well, because these rules still apply to you too. So the YouTube partner program is a YouTube policy as well, and it has its own rules. I advise you, please go and study it and understand what is required of you apart from the 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 hours of watch time, because there are other rules that you need to understand as a content creator on YouTube, whether you are monetized or not monetized. Remember this, the success of the YouTube partner program relies on advertisers willing to associate their brands with YouTube videos. Therefore, YouTube is very strict when it comes to content creators' behavior on YouTube as well as off YouTube, because your behavior has a certain impact on the community, particularly with advertisers on YouTube. How you carry yourself on YouTube is extremely important. That also includes how you interact with your audience. Be respectful. Be respectful of the advertisers on or off YouTube. And also be respectful of your fellow content creators on YouTube. And that also includes your YouTube videos. Are they advertiser-friendly content? Meaning you don't swear, you don't become nude on your videos, you don't demonstrate any sort of violence, or you are demonstrating use of drug consumption, or anything that the YouTube community guidelines forbids. So once you have qualified for the YouTube partner program, then you can make money on YouTube. That also includes running adverts along your YouTube videos. You can create your channel membership. You can also get super chats and super stickers, and now super thanks. Yep, there's a new one called super thanks. I'm gonna talk about that in my other video that is coming up. So if you are going to run adverts on your videos, make sure that you also understand this next policy called advertiser-friendly content guidelines. This is super important for you as a monetized content creator on YouTube, because it's going to determine whether your money is going to be decent enough or very less. That is something that many YouTubers, I don't think they understand how YouTube really pays. CPMs, please, I have already done videos on CPMs and RPMs, what all that means, how you can make more money as a content creator, the type of topics and content that pays more than the others. I can tell you right now, vlogs don't pay. Sorry to tell you, they don't pay unless your vlogs compensate with views, and that's how you will make some sort of decent amount of money. Brands go to YouTube to connect with their potential customers, hence they place ads on our videos. However, it's also important for advertisers to place adverts on channels or videos that align with their principles and values as well as their brands. And therefore, your videos must be advertiser-friendly content. Otherwise, you are not going to make money. However, there are some advertisers that will place adverts on your videos, but unfortunately, you are not going to make the kind of money you hope for. Some people take home as little as 50 cents a month because of the type of content they create. If you are going to talk about sex in your videos or any mature themes on your content, then you must expect not to make as much money as you would expected. Because some advertisers will place ads, but these sort of ads are not the type of ads that are going to pay you decent amount of money. Lastly, I advise you, go and educate yourself about every YouTube policy there is. If you don't know where to get these policies, I advise you to Google. Google is free. It is for your good and for the good of your channel and for your success on the platform, because you need to know what's expected of you and you need to know what's allowed and not allowed on YouTube. Because some people simply think, oh, YouTube, I can just throw in whatever I want, say whatever I want with no consequences. Here, there are strict rules and regulations that you need to follow. YouTube does not play that game. So that is it, my fellow content creators. Thank you so much for watching my video. If you want to join the clan, make sure to smash the subscribe button and don't forget to click the notification bell so that you get notified of all my new videos. And don't forget to like, share, and comment. And I will see you next time on my next video. Goodbye.